Hi, everybody. My name is Marissa, and I have a bachelor's degree in mathematics with a minor in statistics. In today's lesson, we are going to discuss the structure of 2x2 tables, the relationship between a two-sided z-test for difference in proportions and a chi-square test for homogeneity, and when to use Fisher's exact test and McNemar's test. 2x2 tables are exactly what they sound like, a table with two columns and two rows, excluding the total row and column. We use 2x2 tables when working with categorical data, meaning the data is non-numeric. An example of categorical data would be the count of people who voted for a certain candidate in a local election. 2x2 tables are also used to calculate the z-test statistic and z-tests for the difference in population proportions. The formula for a z-test statistic for the difference in population proportions is z equals p hat 1 minus p hat 2 divided by the square roots of the quantity p hat times 1 minus p hat times the quantity 1 over n1 plus 1 over n2. The formula for p hat is the quantity x1 plus x2 divided by the quantity n1 plus n2. The formula for p hat 1 is x1 over n1, and the formula for p hat 2 is x2 over n2. Note that x represents the number of successes. When used with 2x2 tables, conducting a chi-squared test and a two-sided z-test for the difference in population proportions gives us identical p-value results. We know that a test is two-tailed when it contains words such as changed or different, rather than increased or decreased. Let's say that we want to determine if there is a difference in the proportion of a sample of 100 American women 25 and older with a bachelor's degree in 2022 versus 1950. We will calculate both the test statistics and p-values using a chi-square test for homogeneity, as well as a z-test for the difference in population proportions. We will begin by calculating the chi-square test statistic and associated p-value. Using our formula for calculating a chi-square test statistic for a 2x2 table, we obtain a chi-square test statistic of 37.62. Using technology to calculate the p-value, we obtain a p-value of 0.0000, meaning the number of American women with a bachelor's degree in 2020 is different from 1950. Now let's calculate the z-test statistic and p-value. We obtain our values of p hat 1 and p hat 2 by dividing the number of women with a bachelor's degree by the total number of women in the sample. The value of p hat is obtained by adding the total number of women with a bachelor's degree for each group and then dividing by the total number of participants. Now let's calculate the z-test statistic and p-value. We do this by subtracting p hat 1 from p hat 2 and dividing by the square root of p hat times the quantity 1 minus p hat times the quantity 1 over n1 plus 1 over n2. This gives us a test statistic of -6.13 and a p-value of 0.0000. The same as the chi-squared test for homogeneity. This means that the number of American women with a bachelor's degree in 2020 is different than 1950. There are some cases when we cannot use a chi-square test or z-test for differences in two proportions. While we will not dive into calculations for these tests in this lesson, they are important to note since they can be used to analyze 2x2 tables. In cases when our sample size is too small, perhaps 10 or fewer values per cell, we use Fisher's exact test. We can technically use Fisher's exact test for any sample size, but it is more commonly used for small sample sizes. The p-value for this test is found using a probability distribution known as the hypergeometric distribution. When we have paired data that is measured with a categorical response variable, we use McNemar's test. Paired data means that the two groups we are measuring come from the same sample. An example of a use case for McNemar's test would be testing to determine whether or not the proportion of college students who drop out is different after tuition rates are lowered. There are two common mistakes that students make when discussing the methods of analyzing 2x2 tables. The first mistake involves falsely believing that the p-value results for a chi-squared test for homogeneity and a z-test for difference in population proportions are always the same. This is only the case when the z-test is two-tailed. The second mistake involves misunderstanding the meaning of success for our value of x when calculating the test statistic for a z-test for population proportions. For example, let's say we want to calculate the proportion of mice that die when given a new research drug. Although it sounds morbid, the proportion of mice that die is our success in the context of the problem. Let's test our knowledge of what we've learned today with a practice problem. Which method or methods would be best for analyzing a 2x2 table in each situation? Please explain. A manager wants to determine if the proportion of workers who are willing to work overtime increases after a company implements an overtime pay increase. Note that there are greater than 10 values per cell. For question A, a z-test for difference in proportions would be the best option. Because the word increase is used, we know that the test is one-tailed, which means we cannot use a chi-square test. The data also is not paired, so we would not use McNemar's test. Lastly, we have more than 10 values per cell, so we do not have to use Fisher's exact test. Question B. A politician wants to determine if a sample of people's opinions on him changed after watching his latest debate. Note that there are greater than 10 values per cell. For question B, McNemar's test would be the best option since we have paired data. We know we are working with paired data because we are testing the same group of people's opinions before and after listening to the debate. Great job, everyone. Today we described the structure of 2x2 tables. We also learned about the relationship between a two-sided z-test for difference in proportions and a chi-square test. Lastly, we learned about when to use Fisher's exact test and McNemar's test. Thanks for watching, and please be sure to check out other videos about statistics lessons and applications here on Chegg. Have a fantastic day, and I'll see you next time.